Hey folks, Tyrone Farmer. So it's been a second, sorry for that. So I'm back and I got some chicken thighs we're cooking today. And I want to let you know, so right now I got my chicken thighs in milk, but I got it in actually powdered milk. After I added the inner water to it, I powdered it up, I added some salt. And after I added the salt, I added two tops of vinegar. And now I've let it set in this brine for a little while. You can set it as long as you like. After you get it set from there, you can step for step and come over here and I'm gonna teach, pull each one of these out. Set them inside of here. It basically was removing some of the negative particles from it and softening up the meat itself. Now we got it inside the strainer as it strains itself about. And now while we at it, I'm gonna make this make sense, keeping it simple, and I'm gonna verbalize aloud. I'm gonna add a little bit of Cajun seasoning, and then after I added that little bit of Cajun seasoning, I'm gonna add it into my flour bag. And after I've added that, I'm gonna add a little bit of this garlic. I don't have a lot, so I'm gonna stretch it out. I'm adding it onto the chicken. Then I'm going to unpart the other garlic inside of my bag. I'm going to unpart more garlic, but that wasn't enough for me. Some more garlic. I'm going to open the cap up. I'm going to add it into my flour bag. I'm going to a sprinkle of meat tenderizer. I'm going to add some ground paprika. I'm gonna add some to my flour bag. Now I have me some Tony Chasers, I guess you chachas, however you want to say it. I'm gonna add some of this all-purpose seasoning into my chicken. May I have something to my inner bag over here? Black pepper. Add something to my flour bag. Got some onion powder. Now I'm about to add something to my flour bag. Okay, now I'm about to add my last part, which I have some roasted garlic and herbs. Pour it straight into here. Now I'm about to add something to my flour bag. Excuse me, camera guy. Now I'm about to mix this up with my hands. So I use the strainer because for one, get any excess water out, any extra seasoning fall off, falls right on off into through the strainer. Give it a yank. I'm gonna bring this right on over and show you my flour. This is my inner flour right here. So everything I basically already added, which I just verbalized. The only thing I haven't added, which I'm about to add now, is some starch. A little more starch. Now before I do anything, I'm going to shake this bag about and get these mixtures mixed in and parted with each other. Show you what it's looking like when it's mixed. I'm about to add my chicken into it. Now while this is going on, I'm gonna tell you, I have some regular vegetable oil, and I added about almost a half a cup of bacon oil into it. bacon fat, bacon oil, whichever you want to call it, and 2 tablespoons of butter. And I've got it heating over here until a point it gets to that point where it's ready to be fried, which it should almost be there if it's not now. So I'm going to pour all these chicken thighs into the bag. And I double bag it for just in case there's an incident. It's tossed about. Down and back and forth. Let's set it back down. See how we looking. So this is how we looking thus far. I'm gonna check that oil. See how we're doing on the oil side. So we're gonna turn them. So I'm gonna show you the oil. So like I said, that's vegetable oil. We got a cup, well, half a cup of bacon fat and 2 tablespoons of butter. Now I'm about to get these chicken thighs added into here for you to see. You be careful, I don't want to see nobody get burned. It sucks. Right on in, one at a time. Keep those spaced out as much as you can, get them shooken about. Probably should have went with a bigger pan, but this is what I went with for now. Start off with about 4 of them in there. Look for one of my smaller ones to do it. Now I'm gonna keep on letting these boys fry. If they start to rise, that's telling me that they're almost done. It smells very nice right now. The oil, again, it's vegetable oil. Maybe a whole container of vegetable oil and a half. Half a cup of bacon fat. 2 tablespoons of butter. And now it's coming about. And we're trying to get that nice crispy crunch on this chicken. I'll show you how we do it. Again, for my wet batter, it was really more of a soaking. As I took powdered milk and let the chicken soak inside the powdered milk with some salt and 2 caps of vinegar. That really softened it and got some of that extra blood and gunk out of there, which makes it really nice for the chicken in the end when it gets to frying. Hopefully everybody's doing well today. If you're a first timer to my channel, I hope you like my videos. I really hope to get you subscribed, like, and share. Again, I'm Tyrone Farmer, and you know, today we're cooking up some of these good old chicken thighs.